How we doing, everybody?
Great.
Right on. Okay, I'm just letting some people in. Let's have a great call today. Let's have a fun one today. How's that sound? How we say, if it's not fun, why do it, right? Let's have fun. Sandy Miller, good to see you. How are you?
Am good. I have some winning news.
All right, let's hear it.
So I've been advertising my estate planning seminar. We have over 60 people signed up, and a lot of people don't know how to sign up. So there's probably another 10 or 20 that, because I deal with a lot of older folks, right? Which is my specialty and my niche. And I had somebody text me the other day saying that, well, Sandy, I'm in a large church and we are doing a training on helping elderly family members. Would you be interested in coming and sharing your estate planning seminar with us? And I said, absolutely, I will. So that is winning.
That is winning, Sandy. I love it when you're winning. Way to go. Anybody else have something they'd like to share? Something good, something positive.
We've got a listing coming up.
Way to go, Jack. And you've got another baby coming up too.
Oh, yeah.
That's good stuff. I have the pleasure of coaching with Jack and his beautiful wife, Anne, every Monday afternoon. It's good stuff. We rescheduled because of MLK yesterday, yet yeah, we're gonna have one this afternoon. I'm excited. All right,
Tomorrow,
so today.
actually tomorrow morning.
Oh, that's right. You
Right,
Tuesday
tomorrow.
will work for you tomorrow
Yeah,
morning.
yeah,
Thank you
yeah.
for the reminder. I appreciate it. Okay. So any other wins you want to share with us?
I'm a relatively new agent. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. And I've been working with a non-EXP realtor who's a friend of mine that lives out of state. And we actually had a buyer get an offer accepted yesterday. And so I have my first ever contract. Not
Way to
solely
go,
mine,
Jen.
but at least it's a step in the right direction.
That is also winning. Love it when you guys are winning. Way to go. All right, so
Thank
today
you.
I started thinking about, well, what do I want to talk to him about today? I want to talk to you about how you manage yourself in the hours you choose to invest your time. See, I don't call it time management. We can't manage time. We can simply manage ourselves during the time we choose to invest in our work life. And the decisions that we make on the tasks that we're going to complete will really set the trajectory of our life, our lifestyle, our bank account balance, our net worth, our net income, our ability to retire from real estate. It's going to enhance all of that when we make the right decisions as to where we're going to invest our time. Now, as we know, there's all these lawsuits around buyer agency and that the seller had to, quote unquote, had to pay the buyer agent commission. So I think it's really important to invest some time in practice to really nail down your buyer presentation and how you're going to go about doing that, getting an agency agreement signed before you start showing properties. Because with these lawsuits, I would imagine there's going to be some listing agents out there who educate the seller, and the seller says, well, I don't want to pay the buyer agent. The buyer can pay the buyer agent. And you're going to see a 0% co-op right there on the MLS sheet. And if you're not proficient at presenting your value proposition to get them to sign an agency agreement and guarantee you your 2.5 or 3 or 3.5%, whatever you charge, well, it's going to be problematic for you coming up in the future because of the recent trends and lawsuits and everything else. Okay. Now, beyond that, let's get into how to manage yourself during the time you choose to invest in work. Now, out of curiosity, how many of you guys full-time, are there any part-time agents? Okay, I see full-time, part-time.
Time.
Okay, I want to talk about a full-time agent just for the moment and what that might look like from a time blocking perspective. See, most agents, they wake up in the morning, and what do you think the first thing they do is? It's check their
Email.
phone. Their email or their phone and email on the phone, right? Now, the challenge with that, you guys, is that the moment you open your email inbox, you've made a conscious decision to start managing everybody else's priorities instead of your own. So your priority does not exist inside your email inbox, I guarantee you. It doesn't exist inside your social media accounts. It doesn't exist there. There are just three things in the AM hours that I would recommend that you guys do. Five things in total throughout the day, consistently, repetitively. Number one is practice. You got to know what to say. You got to know how to say it. Second is lead generation. And the third is lead follow-up. Those are AM tasks. And I would recommend that you don't open your email inbox, your social media channels until 12 o'clock. I'm not kidding. A lot of people freak out. They're like, come on, John, what if I just got an offer on one of my listings last night in my email inbox? Shouldn't that be the priority? No. No, it can wait until noon. To your priority, just three things in the AM hours, right? Practice, lead gen, lead follow-up. That's it. Now to say, okay, I'm going to time block from 8:30 to 12 every day, 3.5 hour, big chunk of time. It's really hard to stay focused for 3.5 hours. I think you guys would agree. See, real estate, there's all kinds of distractions, front, left, center. They're all over the place. Yet here's one thing I know for sure. Anybody can do anything for just 25 minutes. So let's just say that at 8:30, you do some research around scripts, dialogues. Maybe you get on the phone with a accountability buddy or a role play partner. And you go from 8:30 to 8:55. You set an alarm. And as soon as the alarm goes off, you guys hang up. But you're practicing your craft. And by the way, with mere words, you can make millions of dollars per year selling real estate when you know what to say and how to say it. So the alarm goes off at 8:55. You take a 5-minute break. Go get a fresh cup of coffee. Go for a quick walk. Go use the facilities, whatever you have to do. Then at 9 o'clock, you're going to jump into another 25-minute time block. And let's just say you're going to focus on your lead follow-up. Maybe it's the open house leads from over the weekend. Maybe you're doing some digital ads, social media ads, and you've got leads coming in. So at 9 o'clock, from 9 o'clock to 9:25, you're going to focus on lead follow-up. Those people that have self-identified, raised their hand. They came into your open house. They filled out a web form. They inquired through some social media channel, whatever that might look like. Maybe you're on KV Core and you're spending some money with making it rain through the IDX website, and you got a slew of leads that come in every single day. Okay, then you take a 5-minute break. 9:30, you pick up the phone again. Let's say you call for sale by owners for 25 minutes. Take a 5-minute break. Then at 10 o'clock, you're going to pick up the phone again. You're going to call for sale by owners. Then 10:30, after taking a 5-minute break, you're going to call into your sphere of influence. Just mix it up a little bit. You know, my mentor taught me that it's the masters of the monotony that get on in this game. And yet we can take that monotony and we can break it up and make it kind of fun every single day by mixing up the who we're calling.
What was the fourth one right before the sphere that you said?
Could have been for sale by owners, expired listings, circle prospecting.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's just however you choose to build your time block schedule, right? And maybe you do a 25-minute time block to cast your line into the pond of leads that you've created. Or maybe it's like Sandy reaching out to church directors and talking about this seminar that you can provide to them. I mean, Dave Ramsey did that. He did it at a very high level, I think you would agree, with his financial peace universities, right? And he's got everybody else teaching that stuff and paying him to teach that stuff. You understand? So that's good stuff. I want you to master the 8 hours of the day. Now, anybody can sit down with a pen and paper or an Excel file or even a Word document and build out their perfect week schedule. Meaning, okay, Monday from 8:30 to 12, here's what I'm going to do. Tuesday, same thing, 8:30 to 12. Yet sticking to the time block, that's the challenging part. Now, I want to share a document with you guys real quick. I'm going to share my screen. Bear with me 1 second. Okay, it's coming up now. Now, many of you have seen this in the past, yet I don't care how many times you've seen it. My question is, did you get it? Okay. Here, hold on 1 second. It opened the wrong file. My bad. I'm working a single screen and it's relatively small, so I apologize.
Isn't that the hardest thing to do, is go from two screens to one single screen?
Yes.
Like you're handicapped. I know.
Yes, I feel it. All right.
Whoops, did I lose them?
Okay, finally it pulled up. Here we go. Now I'll share the screen. There it is. Okay, so here's a mistake that I made early in my career, is that I thought I should time block every minute of every day. I didn't put in, you know, take a shower, drive to the office, things like that. Yet you can see the schedule here on the left side. You've got, you know, from 6 a.m. till 7 p.m., 7:30 p.m., excuse me, every day. And then at the top columns, it's days of the week. So yeah, I'd get up, hit the gym at 6:30, I'd work out, then I'd come home, get ready, and then at 8:30, we'd have our team stand up, then we'd script practice, then we got into lead generation. Then I wanted a break to check my emails, return phone calls, then team meeting, or lunch or errands, depending on the day. Then I allowed this spontaneous time. I call it planned spontaneity, meaning educate everybody on my team when it was appropriate to interrupt me. Then it was check emails, return calls again, then it was lead follow-up. Then it was either a client appointment or lead follow-up. So I always had a fallback position if I didn't have the appointment that day. Yet this was my perfect week schedule. And I call it the perfect week because, you know, nothing's perfect. And we get that. Yet The mistake I made was, again, trying to time block every minute of every work day, guys. I was setting myself up for disappointment. It was challenging, to say the least. And I'd finished the day and I was disappointed. Even though I was highly productive, I was just disappointed in myself because I couldn't stick to it 100% of the time. And I was lucky to stick to it, 60, 65% of the time. So as I got older, as I got wiser, I recognized that it wasn't about time blocking every minute of the day. It was about time blocking the AM hours of the day. When your willpower is as high as it's going to get, you're willing to take the risks, you're willing to make the phone calls when your willpower is high. Yet when your willpower is depleted, which happens around noon, by the way, we go back to our default settings. And for most agents that I know, the default setting is, well, I'll just do that work tomorrow instead, right? I don't feel like doing that right now. Yet in the AM hours, and there's scientific research that proves this, our willpower is as high as it's going to get. It's just like battery life on our cell phones, right? Hey, every night you plug it in, every morning you wake up, yep, it's 100%. And yet the more complicated the task it's doing, the faster the battery is depleted. So 8:30 to 12, guys. And then at 12, I honestly don't give a shit what you do. I do whatever you want because you've taken care of your priority. Yet the simple truth is, if you just focused on those three things in the AM hours, the PM hours will be taken care of all by itself with more appointments, more contracts to negotiate. So those are the only five things that are going to move the needle for your production, okay? It's practice, lead gen, lead follow-up. Then it's about going on appointments, negotiating contracts. So I want you to read between the lines here. That means that you don't set showing appointments in the AM hours of the workday. You don't complete final walkthroughs, home inspections, or even closings in the AM hours of the day. I would just encourage you to get hell-bent and focused right now on educating your clients, your prospects, your vendors, that the AM hours are for your priority. A lot of people say, but Sean, what if I got an offer on my new listing and they emailed it to me the night before? Shouldn't I tackle that first thing in the morning? Isn't that my job? Well, sure it is, yet anything can wait until 12. Because let's be honest, anything can wait until 12. Like, unfortunately, I've recently had a neck injury and I had to go in for an MRI and that took 3 hours. Do you think my business was dead when I got out from underneath that machine and after the appointment? No. But I couldn't return emails. I couldn't place phone calls. I had to lock all that stuff up in a locker, man. I was out, completely out of business. Yet my business didn't die. Anything can wait 3.5 hours. That's all I'm saying. Yet take care of your priority first. Because the moment you open that email inbox, guys, you've made a conscious decision to manage everybody else's priorities. Then at 12 o'clock, it's about the cry of the urgent. Imagine you step into a submarine, you close the hatch, you get into this time block. And every minute that goes by, the submarine's going deeper and deeper and deeper. Just recognize the pressure from the outside world, it's building up. And yet then you're going to come back to the surface at 12 o'clock, open the hatch and deal with the cry of the urgent. I know it sounds selfish, self-centered, to say no to the people you care about, the causes you care about. Yet no should be your first response in the AM hours. Because you take care of yourself, you can take care of everybody else at a much higher level. All right, so questions, concerns, challenges, talk to me, gang.
Sounds great.
All right, so the question might become, well, who am I going to call? I'd encourage you to start with lead follow-up because these people have already self-identified. They raised their hand, right? They came into your open house. They filled out the web form associated with your IDX website. These are the people you should follow up with first. That should be your first 25-minute sprint. Then where you go from there, that's completely up to you. Maybe it's your sphere of influence. Again, you've all heard me say it before, contact 2 letters of the alphabet every week, meaning the people in my sphere of influence, my friends, my family members, my past clients, my current clients. If your last name begins with A or B, I'm going to call you this week. If it begins with C or D, I'll call you next week. E or F the following week. And since there are 26 letters in the alphabet, 52 weeks in the year, okay, you'll reach out to everybody by phone 4 times per year. That's once per quarter. Then after that 25-minute sprint, take a 5-minute break. Then maybe you're going to call expired listings. Maybe it's notice of default lists. Perhaps it's for sale by owners, circle prospecting. And just fill up those AM hours with different candidates to contact to earn their business. So that's my input around building out your self-management schedule. Thoughts, concerns, challenges, excitements, ahas, talk to me.
Sean, I just want to chime in here because I think being a realtor, we often think and our families think that we're not busy. So you do have to put that boundary around them, around yourself, really. Like you're saying, you know, you say no to those things and making sure that you're doing that. And also it's not just our family. It's about us too. Oh, I can do that later. I can, especially if you're working from home, I can do the laundry right now. I know that was one of the things that, oh, I need to do this because I need to do it before the peak hours happen. Right. You know? And so really it's getting that thought just around yourself. Right. And we're our own worst enemy 95% of the time in most things anyway. Right.
Oh, undoubtedly. See, transparently, when I get into a time block for, say, lead generation to attract agents to align with me here within my group at EXP Realty, I get into the time block and I open up the dialer and I start clicking the buttons and I'm hearing the phone ring. I'm telling you that I'm begging for a distraction. And I'm just being honest. Like, can somebody please interrupt me? Because I don't know anybody who wakes up every day and says, man, I want to lead generate. I can't wait to be rejected. So we've just got to remain diligent, 25-minute sprint. That's it. Just 25 minutes. You can do it for 25 minutes. I guarantee you.
Well, and Sean, there's also, and you probably know this, these statistics is when somebody, when baseball players are swinging, they practice so many times that they don't get very many hits. They get, you know, but they make a bunch of money. So that's kind of where we need to be thinking. It's, you know, if it's no and you get rejected, oh, well, you know, you just kind of go on. And
yeah, I mean,
you should actually go, yay, I got a no, because pretty soon you're going to get a yes, right?
Yeah, in their world, if they can actually strike the ball one out of three pitches, they're like the best in the business, right? So they strike out two times to hit one ball, ideally, and make a run, whatever the case is. So yeah, I'm with you on that, Sandy. It makes total sense. All right, so four proven strategies to protect your time block, okay? Anybody can build a time block schedule. Yep, first strategy, and Jack will come over to you. I just saw your hand was up. I'll be right back with you, buddy. So first strategy, and I'm going to use military terms, okay? You got to build a bunker. Build your bunker. Where can you go that nobody can reach you? I mean, imagine you're out on the battlefield. Your commander says, retreat, and you're all going to run back and hide in your bunkers, right? This is a place the enemy can't get to you. And again, the enemy is all the distractions, all the shiny objects. Maybe it's your dogs. Maybe it's your kids. Maybe it's your grandkids. Whatever that is, you've got to have that sacred space where you can actually do your work. Like my wife and my kids, they know that if my office doors are shut, they're not allowed to come in. Unless they're bleeding or the house is on fire, you cannot come in. So oftentimes they'll put a sticky note on my door. So it's glass window, so I can see the sticky note. And as soon as I wrap up, I'll come out and I'll check the sticky note. But they know not to interrupt me. This is my bunker. This is my private space. Second thing is you got to sweep for mines. Imagine you retreat to your bunker. You step on a landmine that's in the middle of your bunker. It's going to blow up your time block. So what are your mines? Is it your cell phone? Is it your email? Is it your social media notifications? Put that on airplane mode or give it to somebody else to babysit for you as you're focused on your priority. Or put it on do not disturb mode if you use it for your lead generation and lead follow-up.
Sean, I have a question for you. So doing some listening on some social media and some different things as well, right? And one of the things when you're doing social media, you should be doing that. I guess that would be a lead generation if you were getting in and just posting in the morning or posting on, because you need to kind of do that every day if you want to keep that presence. And so your site doesn't go dry, I guess what you would say, right? So that would be more of the lead generation and just to post and get off and then come back later to look at that post.
That makes total sense. Yes, Cindy. So if that's part of your lead generation model, then just time block the time and stay true to the time block. Meaning, if I'm going to give myself 15 minutes to put a post together, I'm going to stick to 15 minutes or less. All work expands to fill the time allowed, though. So if you gave yourself 10 minutes to do it, you'll get it done in 10 minutes. You give yourself 20 minutes to do it, it's going to take you 20 minutes, right? It's kind of like the day it's the day before vacation miracle, right?
Right.
I think back to your last planned vacation. How productive were you the day before that? You were the poster child of self-management, I'm sure.
Right.
All right. So third category, after you sweat for mines, then it's about storing provisions. Storing provisions. Like when I was president of Keller Williams Maps Coaching, I had a beautiful corner office, windows, all that stuff. And anytime I would leave my bunker, which was my office, let's say it's to get a fresh cup of coffee. That 2 minute trip is about 30 yards to the coffee machine at corporate. That 2 minute trip to walk there, get a fresh cup of coffee and walk back. Inevitably somebody would, oh, Sean, I'm so glad I saw you. Do you have 2 minutes for a quick conversation? I have a quick question, whatever that is. This 2 minute trip to get a fresh cup of coffee turned into a 20 minute distraction. Same thing here. If I leave my bunker at my home office, then guess what? I get sniped.
Free game.
The enemy gets me. So the enemy are the distractions, right? So what do you leave your bunker for? Is it coffee? Bring in a Keurig. Seriously, just fill it up with water that morning. You can make a fresh cup of coffee sitting right at your desk, right? That does create another problem though. Something you might have to leave the bunker for.
Room.
So what I would do is I'd put my phone on silent and I'd have to leave the bunker and I'd hold my phone up to my ear and somebody'd be like, oh, and I'd be like, and then I'd walk into the restroom, use the facilities, then come back out with my phone up to my ear, shut the door. Simple as that. You can bother me after my time block, okay? So plan spontaneity. And that plan spontaneity happens right at 12 o'clock. Get master those AM hours. Okay. So we talked about building a bunker, sweeping for mines, storing provisions, like have Advil. I've got a whole case of water sitting on the floor next to me. Okay. What is it that you leave the bunker for? Is it snacks? I got a whole basket of snacks back here. I got trail mix. I've got all kinds of stuff. Okay. So I can't leave the bunker. Otherwise I'm not nearly as productive. And then final is to enlist support. Enlist support. Educate your loved ones. If you work from home, when it's appropriate for them to interrupt you, when it's not. Yeah, I've got a client down in New Orleans. Her bunker is her master bedroom closet. I'm not kidding. She brought in a card table and she set up her printer and laptop there. And they know if that closet door is shut, they can't interrupt her. So what does that look like for you? Okay. We got 5 minutes left. I want to talk about what you want to talk about now. What's on your mind? What questions do you have? What challenges are you facing right now that we can all brainstorm together, collaborate to help you solve them?
I got a quick question on calling database. Yeah. So I was Mike Ferry trained when I first started. And their script was a little bit more straightforward. Like, hey, who do you know that wants to buy and sell today, yes, right? Within the next 7-10 days. And I find if I just use that script, people don't pick up my call anymore. Yeah. And so I kind of mix it up and start to give them some value prior to just kind of asking for any kind of, if they need any kind of help. And so I was taught that if they don't pick a phone call, if you leave a voice message, a video message, whatever it is, since it's a database call, it counts as a contact. Yeah. And what's your take on that?
Well, I would love to see video text messages sent, no doubt about that, because it evokes all, you know, human response. Okay. 55% of our ability, Jack, as you know, is nonverbal. So a quick video text, they can see the raise of your eyebrows, the smile on your face, right? It creates more of a connection. It allows you to influence, persuade them to do what you want them to do. 38% is our voice volume, pitch, and inflection. So if you leave voicemail, sure, you've got the 38% plus the 7% of the words that you use. Yet that 55% is out the window. I don't believe in counting it as a contact until a live conversation occurs. That does not mean you won't send video text messages or leave voicemails. You're still going to do that. Yet just don't count it as a conversation until that conversation happens. And then the what to say. If you're just doing the direct approach and you're asking for referrals, you can get away with that once, maybe twice per year. Okay, maybe. If you did it every month or every quarter, they're going to ghost you. They're going to block you. Oh, it's Jack. He's calling me again. He just wants more business. Gimme, 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 gimme. Man, he's so greedy, right? Mm-hmm. So I would encourage you to mix that up with client events. Great reason to reach out to somebody to invite them to attend maybe a movie or a happy hour or something simple like that. Yeah. So you're coming from contribution. Another that I picked up from Colette McDonald down in Atlanta, she would just call him up and say, hey, I drove through your neighborhood. Just the other day, I was showing homes to a buyer and it made me think of you. How are you guys doing? By the way, can you believe what property values have done in your neighborhood? And she leads it right into real estate with that one simple question. You know, another would be a gratitude script, something like, hey, Jack, it's Sean Kokoska over at EXP. You know, we worked together a couple of years ago when I helped you buy your house. I just want to call and check in. How are you guys doing? How's the family? You know, by the way, we've got extremely high goals for our organization this year. And one thing I know is that people like each other like each other. And I so enjoyed working with you and your wife, Anne. And you guys are just salt of the earth people. And I know that people like each other associate with each other. Are you with me on that?
Yeah.
And since I loved working with you guys so much, I'm just curious, who do you know right now that's looking to buy a home, sell a house, or invest in real estate that I could call today? So that's more of a direct ask, yet at the same time, you're complimenting them before you ask. Now, the direct ask script is really simple. I call it the referral contest script. Now, I've taught this to hundreds of thousands of agents, and it works, guys. That is, hey, Jack, it's Sean Kokoska with eXp Realty. Thank you so much for taking my call. Hey, today's call is about business. Do you have just 2 minutes to help me with a problem?
Yeah.
You've heard the script before. So I've engaged in this wonderful training program, and it's really designed to help me double, triple, even quadruple my production in real estate sales. And we're having a friendly and fun competition. In fact, I need to get at least 10 referrals, in the next month in order to win. Who do you know from your social circles, maybe church, Instagram, Facebook, that's looking to buy a home, sell a house, or invest in real estate that I should call today? Now, again, you can get away with that like one time per year, maybe twice. Yet I wouldn't do it every month. I wouldn't do it every quarter. Right on.
Thank you.
Oh, my pleasure. All right. So just be interested in people. Figure out how to come from contribution when working with them. And you can't go wrong there. Guys, we're at the bottom of the hour. We're going to cut this off now. Thank you for being here. We do this every single week. So just show up on purpose this week in your business. Show up being productive this week. Time block those early hours of the day, the AM hours. Stick to your time block. Remain focused. And as always, be powerful, gang. See you all next week. Take care.